Hi guys, Aaron Dorr here, policy advisor for the Missouri Firearms Coalition. As you guys know, we've been asking you for the last couple of weeks by email and by social media, what questions do you want to see on the 2018 Missouri Firearms Coalition pre-primary candidate questionnaire? Of course, our candidate survey program is a way that you and I could figure out, you know, which candidates are pro-gun, which candidates just claim to be pro-gun, and which ones are just outright bad when it comes to our right to keep and bear arms. You know, we all know how this game is played. With only a handful of exceptions, every single person running for office in Missouri, especially during a primary season, claims to be 100% pro-gun. And then what happens? We have a massive pro-gun majority in the House and a massive pro-gun majority in the Senate, veto-proof majorities in both cases, and for the last 2 years in a row, our bill to repeal deadly gun-free zones, while has passed two or in some cases three committees, has not been put on the floor because lawmakers who claim to be 100% pro-gun simply won't lead when it comes to the Second Amendment. And make no mistake, it's not that we're bitter because they passed other gun bills, but not our gun bill. These guys haven't passed any gun bills in the last two sessions. So now that the regular session is over, the question now is, who will fight for gun owners if elected for the next two-year cycle of the legislature? So we have here before us right now, this is our final draft of the 2018 pre-primary gun rights candidate questionnaire or candidate survey, picked from the questions that you guys have given us by social media, by email, and by phone over the last couple of weeks, and I guess even the last month or two. Here they are. If you guys see any mistakes, or if you guys see any questions that are missing, please be sure and let us know. You can email us, info@MissouriFirearmsCoalition.org, or you can hit us on Facebook, you can call the office, whatever is convenient for you. But here are the questions that we have. And before I read these off, realize what you can do is hit the link here, print this survey off, and we want you guys to help be the muscle that has always been the Missouri Firearms Coalition's muscle. It's our grassroots members. We want you guys to print this off and take this survey to candidate forums, take it to candidate debates, take it to candidate events, take it to the parades, and give it to them and say, would you take a few moments? It's eight questions long. Take a moment, you know, candidate X, and tell us where you stand on the important issues facing gun owners so that I know, I as in the voters, know how to cast my support in the upcoming primary and general elections. So this is a very grassroots process. We are counting on you guys to print these off and take them to your candidates and urge them to sign the candidate survey. After all, if they won't put their views on paper, you have to ask yourself the obvious question, what are they afraid of? Why will they not sign a simple 9-question candidate questionnaire when it comes to our gun rights? That being said, here are the, the 8 questions in our survey. I'm gonna kind of skim through the background question and ask the main part. Number one, obviously, we've got gun-free zones. Number one, gun-free zones are falsely sold as a way to stop violent crime, but they have been shown to do the exact opposite. Virtually every large-scale shooting in the last few years has taken place in one of these deadly gun-free zones. Let's see, Parkland, Florida, Sutherland, Texas, Las Vegas, Nevada, Orlando, Florida, and dozens more. Missouri code is full of these areas where law-abiding citizens are not allowed to carry defensive firearms. Here's the actual question. If elected, would you support legislation that repeals some of these gun-free zones in areas where the state legislature has control, knowing they only benefit armed madmen looking to rack up a body count? Would you sponsor, co-sponsor, or no, oppose the bill? That is their options. They can sponsor, they can co-sponsor, or they can oppose it. We're not gonna take some mamby-pamby yes on something like this. They can choose to sponsor, they can choose to co-sponsor, or they can choose nothing, but just kind of a generic yes that gets us nowhere. That's question number one. Number two, during the 2016 legislative session, Missouri enacted constitutional carry legislation, which allows law-abiding citizens to carry a defensive firearm without having to add their name to a government database and pay hefty fees. However, in the 2018 session, Representative Peter Meredith introduced House Bill 1733 to repeal constitutional carry law. Here's the question. If elected, would you oppose any legislation that would repeal Missouri's hard-won constitutional carry law? That's question number two. Number three is very similar. It kind of repeats the background. It says that legislation was introduced by Peter Meredith, again, to repeal Missouri's Stand Your Ground law. Stand Your Ground law. Here's the question. If elected, would you oppose any legislation that would repeal Missouri's Stand Your Ground law? Yes or no? Number four, anti-gun organizations often, and especially in Missouri's case, often funded with out-of-state resources from Michael Bloomberg, have been clamoring for legislation to end all private party sales here in Missouri unless they submit to an NCIC check, thereby adding themselves and that firearm to a federal database. As we've seen, this legislation does little if nothing to stop violent crime, but does create a statewide database of firearms and firearms owners, which the Missouri state government has leaked multiple times back in the last couple of years, as you guys probably all know. Here's the question. If elected, would you oppose universal firearms registration legislation? That's kind of a tongue twister. That would ban all private party sales and make criminals out of Missouri gun owners who pass down family heirloom firearms to their children or grandchildren and create a massive government database at the same time. Yes or no, would you oppose that? Question number five. Legislation has been introduced in recent years that would enact a mandatory 3-day waiting period before a citizen could buy a firearm. Let me just kind of skip down here for a minute. If elected, would you oppose any legislation that would place unconstitutional waiting periods that limit when a law-abiding gun owner could purchase a firearm for self-defense? Yes or no? Yes or no? Two more questions, or three, I'm sorry. Number six, in the wake of the Parkland, Florida shooting, anti-gun lawmakers, the media, and Bloomberg-funded activists have been screaming for a complete ban on the AR-15 and hundreds of similar firearms, as well as their standard 30-round magazines and a variety of other features. Let's see here. This, despite the fact that semi-automatic firearms all function the same way. Number six, if elected, would you oppose legislation that bans the manufacture, sale, or possession of a semi-automatic firearm and or large-capacity magazines, realizing that these restrictions do nothing to stop crime but only serve to harass gun owners? This is what we're seeing, for example, in St. Louis with Mayor Crewson and her attempt to make it a crime for you to own an AR-15 or any one of the hundreds of similar, similar firearms. Two questions left. Number seven, mental health has become a backdoor for gun control by expanding the criteria for a voluntary and involuntary mental health commitment and adding more and more people to the NCIC prohibited persons database, often without due process and or full adjudication in a court of law. Once a person's name is placed in this list, it is virtually impossible to have it removed. In most cases, this bill is commonly referred to as red flag orders, which would allow a person to have their gun rights taken away, having never been convicted of a crime at all. So the question is, if elected, would you oppose red flag orders or similar legislation that would deny a law-abiding citizen their gun rights without due process or having gone through a court of law? Yes or no? That's the question. Because what we're talking about here, again, is the idea that anybody could claim that you're a criminal and you're not even allowed to be in the room. It's an ex parte hearing. That has to stop. Last but not least, question number eight. Various state legislatures have already passed legislation that would ban gun rights from American citizens between the age of 18 and 20. In addition, many lawmakers at the state and federal level are publicly calling for this to be enacted at the state level nationwide. This, despite the fact that these are law-abiding Missourians that can serve in the military, pay taxes, get married, have a family, start a career, and enjoy every other aspect of being a legal adult. Okay, maybe paying taxes isn't, you know, one of the good things. Sorry about that. If elected, would you oppose legislation that would leave American citizens between the age of 18 and 20 defenseless and unable to buy a firearm for self-defense? Would you? Those right now, this is the working final draft, the eight questions that comprise the Missouri Firearms Coalition pre-primary gun rights candidate questionnaire. Here's the bottom line. If your candidates will not put their views on paper, then you and I need to be very, very wary of them, because a candidate at election time is the most vulnerable. He needs or she needs our support. So if they're not willing to put their views on paper and lock in the support of a gun owner now, when they're most desperate for votes, how do you think they're going to vote once they're safely in office and two or four years away from their reelection? In my experience, over 10 years of fighting for gun rights in four or five states, candidates who won't sign their surveys often become enemies to gun owners once they're safely in office. So we're asking two things from you guys on behalf of the Missouri Firearms Coalition. Number one, print off your copy of this survey. It's right here, the links above and below. Print off your copy of the survey. Print off a dozen copies. Take them to candidate forums. Take them to candidate events. Take them to the parades. Talk to your legislators. Talk to your challengers. Talk to open seat candidates and tell them, hey, if you want my support, I want you to sign this candidate survey. I want to know where you stand. And guys, if they sign it, rush it back to the Missouri Firearms Coalition. You can mail it to us. The address is across the bottom of the survey. You can scan it to an email, PDF it, and email it to us, and whatever you want to do, but get it back to us so we can have this in our system, so we can show every gun owner in your district where their candidate stands in the fight for the Second Amendment. Again, the optics here, the momentum is changing in Missouri. You know, 2 years ago, we passed the largest state-level gun rights bill in American history in 2016 with Representative Eric Burleson, who's coming back to the Senate, thankfully, we believe, later on this year. But for the last 2 years, we've done nothing. We've done nothing. More than that, in this vacuum, again, the radical anti-gun left is feeling momentum. They're feeling energy. That's why we're seeing bills to repeal our gun rights. We're seeing 10,000 people march in the streets demanding gun control. And we're seeing no action on our bill to repeal deadly gun-free zones. So it's time for these candidates, who then become lawmakers, to act like leaders and actually advance our gun rights instead of just talking about it when they're out there stumping for votes. Your way to help us do that: print off your copy of the Missouri Firearms Coalition candidate questionnaire and bring it to your candidates and tell them to put up or shut up. Guys, lastly, if you're not yet a member of the Missouri Firearms Coalition, we need you guys to help us and be actively involved in this fight. Your membership dollars help fund these programs, and more, and they also help to fund our programs, more importantly, perhaps, or as important, to disseminate these results, so gun owners know who's good and who's bad in the fight for the Second Amendment. We do it through mail. We do it through email. We do it through targeted social media. We do it through radio ads. We do lots of ways to get the word out to gun owners if we have the resources and we need your help. So again, if you're not a member, guys, join up using the links below this video. We need you to be involved in this fight. And finally, share this video with your friends and family so every gun owner knows what's going on. Have them print off the survey as well. Have them take it to events. Heck, if you don't want to talk to them in person, you don't want to confront them, that's fine. Take it, print it off, mail it to them yourself. Mail it to their address on their campaign, on their website, and tell them you want an answer to these simple eight questions so you know who's good and who's bad in your gun rights. Share this video so your friends can help us do that as well. Guys, much more to come in the days ahead. Thank you so much for all of your support so far. We'll be in touch.